It's been a long time. It's been a long time. What up? It's your boy T-Bird Henry Ashton. Today is Music Monday. Before we get things started, prayers up to Scott Hall, who we thought we were going to lose today, but he's all life support, but still breathing. Let's pray that he gets back to a speedy recovery. Well, anyway, now we about to check out the latest from another episode of So What's Up with DJ Premier. I'm back in the order now. And this is from one of the most legendary hip-hop artists of all time, the God, Rakim. This is off his album, It's Been a Long Time. And this is premiere production of the title track itself, It's Been a Long Time. And I actually owned that album as well, too, a while back when it came out on CD. It was a dope album, though. I will say that. At the time, I was young, and my mom was very selective on my music, but she was a fan of Rakim and everything, and I was able to get it with no problems. So, without further ado, let's check out DJ Premier. Take this off, so I don't want people thinking he passed. No, he hasn't. There's no worry, passed. He's still fighting. And let's check out DJ Premier. So, what's up? Episode 10, Rakim. It's been a long time. Let's get it.
What's up, y'all? I'm DJ Premier, and I present to you, So What's Up.
Okay, computer. Run it back.
So What's Up.
1997.
Mm-hmm.
Man, all I can say is my favorite MC of all time. I have so many, but just of all time,
yeah, it was 97.
Never be changed.
I was 8th grade.
Is the God,
I show my
Rakim Allah, of the famous, iconic Eric B. and Rakim. Hands down, it's one of the greatest achievements of my career doing music with him. Outside of the Don't Sweat the Technique album, Rakim ventured out on his own to do some solo work without Eric B. But as of now, they are reunited and back to doing nothing but the livest stuff, and just going to keep on supporting what they've done because they are both incredible artists together and separate. With that said, Rakim took a long, long break, and he's known for taking a long time to release projects with the fans fiending to get more work out of them. So am I. And if you listen to Paid in Full, he said, Rakim, check this out. You go to your girl house, I'll go to mine, because my girl's definitely mad because it took us too long to do this out.
Yep.
And what did Rakim say? Let's just pump the music up. Count our money. Then, on Follow the Leader album, when he dropped the R, he said, you're wondering why the album is late. I was giving you time to get the last one straight.
Yep.
All right. Now, that goes to this. It's been a long time. When I got the call to work with Rakim, and he had been gone a long time, the first thing that came to my mind as a DJ was from the song, I Know You Got Soul, which the first line is, It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you without a strong rhyme to step to. And because of that, immediately I said, that's going to be the best way to approach whatever I do to set off and bringing him back into the community of hip hop to have a lead off record. Now, this record wasn't a video, it was not really, it was serviced by the label just to the DJs, just to warm things up. It wasn't the bigger record because I did other records on that album, which was entitled The 18 letter.
Now, that's what it's called, 18 letter. It wasn't called Been a Long Time, it's 18 letter. I'm tripping, the Book of Life.
Now, during that era, hip hop artists were putting out acapellas, or what we call dub versions, where you would get little pieces of the rhyme, but it wouldn't have all the music in it, so that you could cut it up. Or they would call dubapellas, where it would be sometimes the music is in, then it's taken out, then put back in, but certain parts would have just the rhyme, or just even the 808 popping. Every time Eric B and Rakim did it, they put the 808 behind theirs, but it's all about the 808 anyway, to make them systems pump and the jam in the clubs, or however you listen to it in our era. No digital. This is all analog. Car stereos, boom boxes, Walkmans with cassettes.
You know what I'm saying? Vinyl for us DJs, of course. And them sound systems, man. So that was already my approach. And I'm known for doing a lot of stab-oriented records where the sounds may be just short, but they have melody or some type of flavor to it where the stabs work in how I approach it when I put it to drums. This right here was really where I wanted to go with it. Everybody knows the famous Call Me from Al Green.
Call Me, yeah.
I did an alternate version that was not affiliated with the Al Green original record, but I did it in stab form from an alternate source. The alternate source just happened to go right with my drums. I'm very particular about drum choices to go with the music. That's the reason why I do it how I do it. Mm-hmm. A lot of my records always have an intro to make you start it,
yep,
so that you can bring it in a certain way, because DJs like to always cut the beginning a certain way. I already knew I was gonna take the It's Been a Long Time acapella from I Know You Got Soul. We had a count, shout to Eddie Sancho, shout to D&D Studios, Dave and Doug, which is D&D. We had that 10-second count, but we also had a click. A click is just a track that has a click. It's a metronome. A lot of people that know about piano lessons and everything, even the old school metronomes just go click, click, click. You can speed it up, you can slow it down. Now the world we come through with sequencing, which at that time the Roland SBX80 was our sync box that would make everything go together to play. We used the click track where once I knew I was about to drop it on the one, I already knew how many bars it was, so I could go, it's been, you know what I mean? And there it was. As we say, once you load this into the S950 sampler, you get this. It's been a long time. It's been a long time. When I gave it to Rakim, who was there when I created the beat, and shout to his brother Stevie Blass, all those keyboards and everything you heard on like Paid in Full's Move the Crowd and Follow the Leader, all those heavy, mean gangster sounds, that's his brother, Stevie
Blass.
Wow. Shout to him. He was there, and I remember he just went in the booth, did it. The label was so hyped about it, even though the album wasn't ready, because it was a double album. He did the album, The 18th Letter, and then he also handpicked songs from his catalog with Eric B. and Rakim to make it a double CD, double vinyl album. And then he also did just a single one. The 12-inch was actually released as more as a promo, a white label promo, vinyl only. And when they put that out and all the DJs started to spin it, right after that, the album came. Once it was out to the world, then the plaques came. And I got my copy of my plaque. The 18th letter plaque is right here, as you can see right there in front of your eyes. And I thank you, Rakim, for having me be a part of it. It's one of the most monumental parts of my career, and I'm so grateful. And I gotta be grateful to this, because this is where it came from once it was put into motion. Gotta salute the floppy disk. It's been a long time. How long has it been again to be in the state of mind that Rakim is in? It's been a long time.
Rakim, the microphone solo with. It's been a long time. All right, cool. Another great episode of So What's Up with DJ Mir. Salute to the floppy disks. Next week, another GameStar classic and a favorite of my GameStar as well too. I won't tell you what it is unless you follow this. Unless you follow this channel and the So What's Up series in order, you'll get an idea. But other than that, if you like my reaction, like, share, subscribe my YouTube channel. You might get a little hint right there in one of the thumbnails, but it's your boy T-Bird signing off. One love.